Okay, in previous lecture, we discussed the force, torque and strain measuring instrument, where we discuss each and every part, each and every device in detail. Now we discuss about pressure measuring instrument, where how we have to measure the pressure in industry or in the our daily purpose, that we discuss in this current lecture. Before I start the lecture, I just give some introduction about the pressure. Pressure, that we know very well, is an essential component of everyday life of human being. If we talk about atmospheric pressure, like blood pressure, gauge pressure, vacuum pressure, etc., right? So it becomes imperative to know the element detail about pressure and its measurement. Pressure can define in many ways, as you can just see in the diagram. That pressure is a force exerted by a medium, usually fluid or a unit area. So measuring device usually register a different pressure, like a gauge pressure. Pressure is also defined as force exerted over a unit area. Means we can say that pressure is equal to force upon area, where force is in the Newton and area is in the meter square. So we are considered that Newton per meter square, or it may be considered as a Pascal. You remember that Newton per meter square, or it may remember as a Pascal. Other unit, the relation between Pascal and bar is 1 bar is equal to 10 raised to 5 Pascal. So that you have to remember, and sometime it may be asked in your exam the relation. Now come to the point that classification of pressure measurement. As you can see here, it may classify in two ways: mechanical measuring instrument and electromechanical measuring instrument. If we talk about the basics about mechanical measuring instrument, then manometer, U-tube manometer, well type manometer and inclined manometer. These are the basic types of classification that we discuss later. Then electromechanical devices. Before that, mechanical may divide in two ways, as I discussed earlier. The first one, which we manometer, that from bellows and burden to pressure gauge are there. If you talk about as per the shape point of view, then diaphragms are divided in three ways: flat type diaphragm, corrugated type diaphragm and capsule type diaphragm. If you talk about the burden to pressure gauge, then it may divide in C type, helical type and spiral type. So these are the basic about the classification of pressure measuring instrument. Now, before start the measurement of pressure, it is very important that the scale of pressure measurement that you should know. For that, I just show you one relevant video. So from that video, you understand that the gauge pressure, barometric pressure, vacuum pressure and absolute pressure. And then we go in depth. As we know that pressure is the physical force exerted on a object, as we discussed earlier. You can just see in the diagram, so it's very clear in your mind that one object is given to you and one area is there. On base on that area, if we apply some pressure, if we apply some force, then force per unit area, it is called as a pressure. So pressure P is equal to force divided by area. Now we discuss about types of pressure. Initially, we discussed the method of measurement of pressure. Okay, it may divide in two ways. Now, types of pressure, as I discussed earlier, some names. that now discuss in detail. Suppose this is the datum line, and that line we are considered as atmospheric pressure. Then above that atmospheric pressure, whatever we are getting, it is called as a gauge pressure, which is measured above the local atmospheric pressure. You remember that, which is at sea level, it is considered as the atmospheric pressure, and beyond that, above the sea level, it is considered as a gauge pressure, while below the gauge pressure, it is known as a absolute pressure, or we are considered it as a vacuum pressure also. Okay, so sometime it may ask in your exam that what is absolute pressure? So absolute pressure is nothing but it is the summation of atmospheric pressure and gauge pressure. Okay, so you have to remember that atmospheric pressure and gauge pressure is called as absolute pressure. And another time it may ask that atmospheric pressure is also known as a barometric pressure. So you have to remember the relation between gauge pressure, atmospheric pressure and absolute pressure relation. You remember another thing, that vacuum is given to you. So we are considered that the vacuum is equal to atmospheric pressure minus absolute pressure. You remember that vacuum pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure minus absolute pressure. Atmospheric pressure, as discussed earlier, that it also known as the barometric pressure, as the force per unit area exerted against a surface by the weight of the air above the surface, then it called as a atmospheric pressure. Definitely pressure at sea level is mostly approximately we are considered as a atmospheric pressure. So it is considered as a 1 atmospheric pressure. The relation, you remember that 1 atmospheric pressure is equal to 760 mm of Hg or 14.7 psi or 101 kilopascal, or we are considered at 1.013 bar. Okay, so these are the some units and relation of atmospheric pressure. Now gauge pressure is the pressure relative to atmospheric. Definitely, we are measured with the help of some gauge. That's why it is known as a gauge pressure, which is used the pressure difference between a system and the surrounding atmosphere. The instrument which shown in the diagram, it is known as a indicator of gauge pressure, which indicate in the unit of PSI. Hence, pressure gauge reading is shown at atmosphere. Okay, so G indicate for gauge pressure. Sometimes G is mentioned, or mostly they are not mentioned the G. So if G is mentioned, then it call as a gauge pressure. Now third one, very important, that is vacuum pressure. When the pressure to be measured is less than local atmospheric pressure, is called as a vacuum pressure. In other words, when the gauge pressure is negative, you remember that when the gauge pressure you are getting negative, then it called as a vacuum pressure. Vacuum pressure means atmospheric pressure minus absolute pressure. Okay, so we have get the sign is the negative, as you can see in here in the diagram. And in actual scenario, perfect vacuum is never possible. So it is not observed anywhere in universe, right? So that you have to remember. 10 raised to minus 10 atmospheric pressure. 10 raised to minus 10 atmospheric pressure. It is the one of the measurement of vacuum pressure. And the unit is TOR, T-O-R-R. Next one, very important, that is absolute pressure. Pressure above absolute zero is called as absolute pressure, as you can see in the diagram. Absolute pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure. Okay, so you just remember this thing, that 14.7 psi plus 30 psi means 44.7 psi. Means, suppose sometime asking your exam that the atmospheric pressure, the value of atmospheric pressure and the value of gauge pressure is given to you. And suppose if you want to find this, then you have to do the summation of these two. Suppose sometime in MCQ it may ask like that, only gauge pressure is given to you and absolute pressure is given to you, and you have to find this. So based on that, you may remember the relation, that absolute pressure is the relation between atmospheric pressure and gauge pressure, and you are find the answer. Last one, differential pressure. Based on that, we are discuss some measuring devices of the pressure. Definitely from the name, we can say that it is a difference in pressure between two points. Okay, suppose pressure at point one is something and pressure at two is point something. It may not zero. So on that time, higher pressure minus lower pressure, so we are get the differential of the pressure. Okay. There are two node given to you, so we are definitely find the difference of higher pressure and lower pressure. Okay, now it is important to understand the basics about the pressure. That's why I explained regarding the gauge pressure, barometric pressure, vacuum pressure, and absolute pressure. Now, methods of measurement. Already we are classified the methods of measurement. So we are start one by one. Before that, initially we start the pressure measuring scale, I just classify the pressure measuring instrument. If, as we discussed earlier, that it may divide in this way, like mechanical way and electromechanical way. And in mechanical way, it may divide in two ways, static and dynamic. Now, electromechanical, if you consider, then it may divide in potentiometer, potential electrocapacitor pressure measuring instrument, piezoelectric type of pressure measuring instrument, and inductive type of pressure measuring instrument. Okay, so you have to remember the classification of pressure measurement instrument. Sometime it may ask in your exam also that classify the pressure measuring instrument. So on that time, it is very important. Now, in pressure measurement, start one by one. First one is the U-tube manometer. As the name suggests, the shape is like a U-tube. So the name is U-tube manometer. Mostly manometer is used as a differential of the pressure. If you see in the diagram, then in the following section, the working of the manometer has been discussed. sometimes used as a primary standard for pressure measurement. You just seen the diagram, so it's very clear in your mind that in industry it may also very helpful to use. Most probably the fluid use is water and mercury in manometer. In your tube manometer, high pressure is very easily measured. And as seen in the diagram, you can see in here that two pressure are given to us. So pressure P2 is indicate in the diagram, and pressure P1 is also indicated in the diagram. Two limbs, often made of mostly steel, or sometimes it may be made from the glasses also. When one limb is of much larger diameter than other, so high pressure P1 to the narrow limbs have a cross section of A1, and a lower pressure of P2 to the limb having a cross section of A2, right? So differential pressure that we have to measure, and the difference of that pressure we are very easily measure with the help of U-tube manometer. Here the expansion of fluid field in the manometer affect the density and also thermal expansion of the readout scale, which may affect the precision of the measure. Better precision in manometer can be accomplished by, if we require the better precision, then sometimes we are attached sensors with capacitance or sonar device instead of visual read out scale. And if we talk about the limitations, then manometer have some limitations, like definitely the construction is somewhat simple, but and also less expensive. So that's why it mostly preferable for the device of measurement, very popular in industry also. So sometimes it may also use for the calibration purpose. One of the major disadvantage of manometer is that the filling fluid may vaporize at high vacuum or temperature. And other limitation include toxicity of mercury, thermal expansion of fluid, and readout scale affecting accuracy of the measurement, variations of density. Sometimes corrosion problems are there, and evaporation of the fluid, and high temperature conditions. So these are the some basic limitations that we face when we use the mercury as a fluid and in the manometer. But most probably it may be the less expensive. That's why it may preferable to use in the industry. One thing that I think you remember, that it may not stick to the tube, right? So this is a very important advantage of tube manometer. Now, well-type manometer is widely used because of the inconvenience reading of the only a single leg. Okay, in YouTube there is a reading, but it may not properly given, so we are not get the exact reading. So on that time we have preferred to use well type manometer, which look like this way, so the readings are very clearly considered or taken by the observer. It consists of a very large diameter vessel, right? Very large diameter vessel connected on one side to a very small size tube. Okay, so there are, you can just see in the diagram, so it's very clear in your mind that one side the vessel is very large diameter, while the another side the vessel is very small size. Thus, the zero level moves very little when pressure is applied, right? Only small level still we are, if it may goes down or above, still we are get the higher sensitivity in the smaller size diameter. It means that the sensitivity of this well type manometer is very high. And if you want to find the difference, then the equation we are prefer is rho gh. That you have to remember that P1 minus P2, a differential between the pressure is considered as a P1 minus P2. After that, inclined tube manometer. Inclined tube manometer, definitely as shown in the figure, have two limbs. One of the limb is narrow glasses tube and the inclined at an angle theta as seen in the diagram with the horizontal. The other limb is at cistern, which is of the wider cross section. Assume that the narrow and wider limbs have the cross section area A1 and A2. So we are getting that, as we know that P1 minus P2 is equal to rho gh. But in place of here, we have to use P1 minus P2 is equal to rho g in the bracket d in the bracket d plus l sine theta, right? Here l is there, so l sine theta. P1 minus P2 is equal to rho g, or in place of h we are put d, small d, it is equal to the diameter of smaller limb plus l sine theta. Now we know that a1, capital a1 d1 is equal to capital a2 d2, so we are get the value that p2 by p1 is equal to rho g x in the bracket a2 by a1 plus sine theta. Okay, where we put a1d is equal to a2d. Okay, a1d is equal to a2d. And we have put the value of, we are just keep this value, the diameter of this value alone, and we are get whole value. So we are get the value that P1 minus P2 is equal to rho g x in the bracket a2 by a1 plus sine theta. Okay, so this is the basic thing that is important when we use the inclined manometer. Burden tube pressure gauge. It is the really important whenever we are suggest or we are used to use in industry. It is most widely used gauge for pressure measurement. First developed by E. Burden, and that's why the name is Burden tube. If you see in the diagram, then it look like a C shape, which is made from the hollow metal tube having elliptical cross section. One end of the burden gauge is fixed and can be used at pressure inlet. Okay, one end is fixed and can be used as a pressure inlet. The other end is free and closed. The other end is free and closed. Due to the applied pressure, the tube straightens out and tend to acquire a circular cross section, right? So the pressure caused the free end to move. So what happened? The pressure, due to the applied pressure in the inlet, it may start to move. Thus, pressure caused the free end to move, and this movement is proportional to the difference between inside and outside pressure. and that we are indicate with the help of some indicator or some scale. The point to indicate gauge pressure, in case of higher sensitivity, the burden tube may be formed in helix containing several turns, right? That you have to remember that. Sometimes helical, twisted or spiral forms are also used to get or to achieve the higher accuracy. We have preferred the burden tube pressure gauge for 500 megapascal. Okay, up to 500 megapascal, we have preferred to use burden tube pressure gauge. Now I one relevant video. Whatever we have finished till now, that we cover in this video. Some relations are as discussed earlier that mentioned here. Whatever we have finished till now, that we trying to finish. Absolute pressure, gauge pressure, differential pressure. Please read it very carefully. Each and every word is important. till now, anybody have any queries up to end of this point of up to burden tube and manometer, then they may raise the query or they may mention the comments in chat box. YouTube manometer. Please read the principle, because to understand the working of YouTube manometer, as earlier I discussed, then it is very important to understand that hydrostatic law. Based on that, it may work. The capacitance between two plates change with the distance between the plates, and in based on that we are prefer or we are measure the pressure with the help of capacitor. Now piezoelectric devices, with the help of piezo, we are preferred to measure the pressure, where we know that whenever piezo is come in the picture, then crystal or quartz is come in the picture. So based with the help of that, we generate the electricity, and that may charge when they are strained. Okay, so that strain which is proportional to the applied pressure, and we are measure the pressure. So this kind of devices also you may use to, you may design and you may start to prepare for your open-ended problem or for your design engineering point of view. Okay, so you just remember and you just find that how we can grow our basic things for or how we are adjust with our knowledge with the technical point of view, right? So these are some basic things that we are discuss. Now diaphragm, LVDT and bellows are remaining that we are discussing in the next lecture. But I just show you if video I have, then I just show you one video regarding the relation of pressure measurement that we had discussed earlier. I think manometer is yet remaining. So I just show you that all kind of manometer. Because sometime it may ask in your exam that classify the manometers only. Okay, so it is very easy for you. We just see that there are basic manometer shown at here, that is simple manometer, gauge pressure manometer, vacuum manometer, and two tube manometer. Okay, so based on that, the manometer are classified, which are not discussed earlier. So I just show you this video because it is very important that in simple manometer, we are directly measure the height of the concern liquid, and that may directly proportional to our pressure, and we are finding the pressure. Okay, it is called as a simple manometer, and pressure is equal to rho g into height, density rho, g for gravity and h for height. Okay, we are going to directly measure the pressure of A, means is C point ka hum pressure directly measure karenge with the help of simple manometer. Now, gauge pressure, where we are measuring the pressure with two kind of height. We are get, so based on that we just find the pressure of both the thing, the curvature we are getting after that, it may be whenever we are considered that it may be straight line, it is considered the datum line. And from the that datum line, we ensure that AA or XX we are consider, and then we find the pressure. That pressure at this point means PB, right? Here we are considering it as a B. So the pressure of B, the height that is for first liquid, so the density of that liquid, gravity of that liquid, and height from datum to edge. So that is everything about the pressure on left side. Now we are talk about pressure on right side. So pressure on right side is equal to aisa kuch limb nahi hai. So only the pressure is equal to rho gh. So rho 2, here second fluid is there. So rho 2, gravity and height, it is h2. So it is called as a rho 2 gh2. Now, dono ko hum compare karenge. So pb plus rho 1 gh1 is equal to rho 2 gh2. Okay, and we have to find the pressure of b, that is equal to rho 2 gh2 minus rho 1 gh1. This is the pressure of point B that we have to find. Now we know that whenever we are get the minus pressure or negative gauge pressure, it is called as a vacuum pressure, that we have to find. Whenever talk about the negative pressure, then we are get the height in this way as discussed in current B kind of figure. Okay, so you have to, whenever you have to find the vacuum pressure, then the whole arrangement is like that. One fluid is there, another fluid is here, and definitely both fluid are not mismatched with each other. If we consider that and the pressure of point B, then kya hoga, ye pura aa jayega. It means pressure of point B plus rho 1 gh1 plus rho 2 gh2, right? But if we talk about the right side, then there is nothing. Okay, height bhi nahi hai or liquid bhi nahi hai. So we are getting that pressure of point, and we have to now compare both the things. So PB plus rho 1 gh1 plus rho 2 gh2 is equal to right side means zero. So PB is equal to negative of or minus of rho 1 gh1 gh1 plus rho 2 gh. Okay, so this is the minor things that we have to remember whenever we proceed for the vacuum pressure. Now our differential manometer, where same thing we have to apply and we have to find the pressure difference between point A and point B. Here also once again we are use two limbs and both are filled with the different pressure, and we have to find the difference between pressure PA minus PB or PB minus PA. Okay, let's start one by one how we are find the pressure. Suppose at point A the liquid is rho 1, the density of that is rho 1, and the liquid at B at density is rho 2, and between that two we are fill it with the mercury whose density is rho hg. Okay, after filling one liquid, second liquid and mercury, whatever we are created or we are getting, that is height we are measure, the difference of height of mercury, difference of height of second fluid and some liquid in the pressure A. Okay, so based on that we are consider that the pressure on left side, that is equal to pressure PA plus हियर डेंसिटी इसकी आएगी रो वन जी, एंड हाइट ये पूरी हाइट है दैट वी कंसीडर दैट एच इनटू हाइट ऑफ एच इनटू फ्लूइड एंड एक्स. ओके वी आर कंसीडर दैट द टोटल हाइट इज एच ऑफ फ्लूइड ऑफ एक्स. नाउ टॉक अबाउट द राइट साइड. सो पीबी दैट इज श्योर. देन रो जी एंड वाई, हाइट को हमने अभी वाई बोला है, सो रो जी वाई एंड रो मीन्स एच जी का रो है जी एंड हाइट ऑफ दैट एच जी. नाउ वी जस्ट कंपेयर द राइट साइड विद द लेफ्ट साइड. So we are saying that PA plus rho g, rho 1 g HFX is equal to PB plus rho 2 gy plus rho hg into gh. See, rho hg is the density of the mercury and h is the height of the mercury. Okay, so we are get PA minus PB is equal to rho 2 gy plus gh in the bracket rho hg minus rho 1 minus rho 1 gx. Okay, so that you have to remember, this is the basics about manometer. Okay, so sometime ask in your exam for example point of view, still you can explain it in the proper way. Now remaining things, that is diaphragm and bellows and LVDT, that we discuss in the next lecture. So if you have any query regarding today's lecture, then you may either comments in the comment box or you may raise the hand. Okay.